UNDP is one of the largest development agencies for the whole United Nations system. We started the Millennium Development Goals that come to an end at the end of this year. And at the same time, the government is already thinking, the governments all over the world are thinking of putting in place Sustainable Development Goals. There are 17 of these goals, and the one major difference about these goals is that they are universal, unlike the Millennium Development Goals that primarily referred mainly to developing countries in terms of the 8 objectives that we had to meet. These are for all, and they relate to sustainable development. They talk about sustained, inclusive economic growth and productive employment. They talk about promoting peaceful and inclusive societies. We just took 2 of those goals which directly talk to the subject at hand. They are talking about the entire spectrum of what sustainable development, what inclusive development, what equitable development would mean for us. And implicit in that also is, without access to justice, without accountability, it's very difficult to have a society that will have citizen security. And Ms. Sutherland had also mentioned the whole idea of a cohesive society. That is what we are focusing on. That a cohesive society where we are looking after the well-being of all its constituents, all the members. We are fighting exclusion, marginalization. You must have a sense of belonging. You must trust each other. And there are opportunities for everyone, each individual, whether whichever communities they're living in, inner city or otherwise, so they also have opportunities to improve their quality of life and have those options. So if we are talking about social inclusion, social capital, and social mobility. Now, when I'm looking at currently, we do have a high unemployment rate. You know, in 2007, we did tremendously well. We were already on target to meet the first Millennium Development Goals to reduce poverty by 50% and provide adequate nutrition. Then the unemployment rate increased. But what is more important, the reason we put it there, is that the unemployment rate amongst the youth is twice that of the national rate. And also inequalities. Whenever there are serious inequalities in any part of the world, we are unequal, but we are certainly not as unequal as the United States. But nevertheless, that inequality, when you look at the top decile and the bottom decile, you're talking about 30% of assets versus 2% of assets. And what that does, when inequality exists, the wealthy class does not invest in public goods, which are extremely important to have social cohesion, trust building, and how we move forward. Issue of unemployment, we mentioned, poverty, and then there's also an issue of unattached youth. That youth have to be engaged productively. One of our experiences has been where the youth have very clearly told us that whenever there are jobs, the guns vanish. When there are no jobs, the guns come out. Very revealing statement. It is, we need to engage the youth. We need to provide them options. You know, they are going to be a future leader. We need to work together, and now those would be the seeds of social cohesion, just trust building. It's going to be a slow process. We will make progress in baby steps. But the engagement of diaspora becomes extremely important because they not only bring the learnings from where they are, the good practices from where they are, they can bring those to us to say, this is what will work, but then they can also create additional opportunities for youth as they look for options. Even if the weather is tied to business here, they work in agriculture, what those opportunities exist and what mentorship we can all jointly provide to them. Thank you very much.